Welcome to Excellent CAD. My name is Ajay Anand. In this video, I will explain 5 different methods to import text files into Excel. Here is the first method. To import the data present in this text file called points1 into an Excel workbook, select the text file. Holding the left mouse button, drag the file into the workspace of Excel and release the mouse button. We have the data in the text file called points1 in an Excel workbook. To open multiple text files in Excel, select the files. Holding the mouse button, drag and drop the files into the workspace of Excel. Both files are opened, but in separate workbooks. Now the second method. To open this text file called points2 in Excel, right click on the text file, open with, select Excel from the available options. Now the third method using Power Query. Power Query can be used to import a single as well as multiple text files into Excel. At first, we will see how to import a single text file into Excel using Power Query. Go to the Data tab of Excel ribbon, from text/CSV. Using this dialog box called Import Data, select the file to be imported into Excel. I will select this file called points2. Here we have the preview of the text file called points2.txt. To load this data into Excel, click on Load. Data present in the text file called points2 is loaded into the Excel worksheet. Let us cross-check the values. Now to import multiple files, that is to import all text files in this folder called points. In the Data tab, get data, from file, from folder. Here we have to specify the path of the folder containing text files. For that, we'll copy this file path, copy. Back to Excel, get data, from file, from folder, paste the copied path, OK. All those text files present in the folder called points are listed here. To combine the data present in these files and to load it into an Excel sheet, click on Combine and Load. Or else, if you want to make some changes in the data, I mean to transform or shape the data, click on Combine and Transform Data. OK. Data present in those 3 text files is loaded into the Power Query Editor. First column contains the file name, points1.txt, points2.txt, and points3.txt. Now if you want to add a new column for serial numbers, add column, index column, from 1. You can also modify the column headers if you want to. I will change this column header to file name. To remove .txt from the file names, right click on the column, replace values, type in .txt, OK. .txt has been removed from the file names. And if you want to remove a particular column, right click on the column header, select remove. Right now I am keeping every column as it is. Now to load this data into an Excel sheet, in the Home tab, click on Close and Load. Data present in those three text files of the folder called Points has been imported into Excel. Let us cross-check the values. The advantage of this method is that whenever I add a new text file in this folder, data in that text file will be automatically imported into this Excel file. For that, I just need to click the refresh button in the data tab. Let me show you what I mean. Here we have two text files called points4 and points5. We'll copy these files into the folder called points. Right click, copy, paste. For our Excel file to update for the addition of these two new files, click on the refresh button in the data tab. Points4 and points5. Let me open this file so that we can cross-check the values. .478 .221.311. The fourth method to import text file into Excel is using Power Pivot. We'll close this file. To import a text file using Power Pivot, in the Power Pivot tab, click on Manage. And we have the Power Pivot window. Click on From Other Sources. In the Table Import Wizard, select the last option, Text File. Next, to select the text file, browse. We'll select this file called points5. Open. Specify the column separator, tab, finish, close. Data present in the text file called points5 is now loaded into the Power Pivot window. To load this data into an Excel sheet, close the Power Pivot window. In the Data tab, Existing Connections. Here is the connection to the text file called points5, and you can see that it is already selected. Open. Select the cell where you want to load the data. I will select the cell C3. OK. Data present in the text file called points5 is now loaded into the Excel sheet. Now the fifth method to import text file into Excel, which is using a macro. To create the macro, go to the Developer tab. Click on Visual Basic. Right click on the tree view present in the left sidebar. Insert, Module, SUB. We'll name this macro as Import Text File. Declare in memory, TEMPR string. Open, space, double quotes. Specify the path of the folder containing the text file to be imported. To import the text file called points3 from this folder called points, copy the folder path. Paste the copied path. Now the file name, / points3.txt, double quotes, space, for input as 1, Now the address of the cell where you want to place the data. I want to load the data into the cell H3 of this worksheet. For that, range H3.select. Do until end of file 1, input #1, comma, temp, active cell dot value equal temp, active cell dot offset 1,0.select. Now to close the do until loop, loop close 1 to close file number 1. Close the VB editor, macros. The macro called import text file is listed here. Click on run to execute it. Data present in the text file called points3 is loaded into the cell H3 of the active worksheet. I hope you will find this video useful. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe and press the bell icon so that you won't miss anything. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.